So let's start with your sitting. See whether how your sitting comfort position. You don't have to sit in cross leg. You can also extending the leg out. You can sit with one leg to the back. Whatever that allowing your sitting bone to be down toward the floor. Then rock your torso side to side. Shift the weight from one sitting bone to another. If you're noticing that your hip is tight and you sit slouching, maybe using the block by sitting on top of the block will help elevating your hip higher. When your hip is higher, it tilts your pelvis forward. So bring your knee down, connecting down more toward the floor. So try it out, especially those who have lower back pain. Then find yourself stillness, breathing in, left both shoulder up. Breathing out, roll the shoulder apart away from your sternum, drop your shoulder down, relax your elbow down. A few more rounds. So inhale, lift up tall, exhale, softening to your shoulder, neck, and jaw. Keep your shin parallel toward the floor. Draw your neck back so that the neck is in line with your spine. Then feel the weight of your elbow relaxing to your arms, hands down to your thigh. Inhale, tilt the chin up, gazing up gently to open up the front of the throat. Exhale, draw your chin down toward your chest. Inhale, tilt the chin up, relaxing to the front. Draw the chest up, and as you exhale, gently squeezing into your belly, draw your chin down. Breathing in, roll your right ear toward your right shoulder. Exhale, bring your chin back toward the center. Inhale, roll your left ear all the way to the left side of your shoulder. Exhale, draw your chin back down. One more time on each side. Inhale, right ear, right shoulder. Exhale, draw your chin down toward your chest. Breathing in, left ear, left shoulder. Exhale, back toward the center. Breathing in, lift both shoulder up toward your ear. Exhale, drop it down, bring your chin down. Now gazing down toward the floor or closing your eye. Taking this time to follow your breath inside your body. Draw yourself inward so that you can focus in on your breath, one breath at a time. Try not to change any patterns of your breath or forcing your breath, but let it flow. Each time you inhale, drawing refreshing air to both nostrils. The exhale, releasing all the stale air out from your body so that you find the emptiness inside. Just breathe, relaxing to the face and jaw. Breathing in, lengthening to your spine. Breathing out, softening to your shoulder. Inhale and exhale. On the next in-breath, see whether you can draw the air in a little bit more. Filling up your lung capacity. You might noticing the chest begin to expand. Maybe ribs out to the side. And as you exhale, releasing the air out from your chest, hug your ribs in toward the spine, empty the air out from your stomach. Try it again, breathing in, long, slow, deep breath. Let the diaphragm drop it down to the bottom of your pubic bowl. You might noticing your belly begin to rise. Ribs expand up toward your chest. Breathing out, softening to your chest, ribs, and belly. Continue a few more rounds like this. Smooth, steady flow so that your mind can find the quietness and stillness. Taking the time to draw yourself to arrive here into this present moment. Inhale fully, exhale completely. Then begin to connecting your breath to what your body. scanning through from the crown head all the way down to your toe, noticing how your body feels. If you're noticing any previous injury or any tension or tightness somewhere today, sending the breath energy towards the area that you feel tightness. At the same time, taking modification or adjustment you may need. Whenever you experience pain, just backing off by listening to your body. If you're new to yoga today, welcoming yourself and practicing within your range of motion. In the next couple breaths, taking your time to set up the intention of your practice. What brought you here today? And slowly find your way back to your natural breath. If you're closing your eyes, then gently open up your eyes. Breathing in, draw the arms out, reaching it up toward the sky. Breathing out, release, draw your arms open down, bring your arm and fingertips down. Couple more times in sun breath, inhale, lengthening from your waistline up, reach the arms up. Exhale, palm facing down, fingertips down. Try it again one more time. Flip the palms up. It will be easier for your shoulder, especially if you have tight shoulder. Breathing out, palm facing down, softening to your shoulder. Then bring your hands in front of your knee. Begin to circle your hips, your shoulder, making the movement to your elbow. Feel the stiffness from this one sitting bone to another. Then reverse the circle to the opposite side. Pause right here at the center. Lift your torso up, breathing in. Exhale, turn your left shoulder toward your right knee. Hinging forward from the head, turn the gaze, look at the back of the room. Inhale back toward the center. Exhale, twist and turn your right shoulder toward your left knee. One more time on each side. Inhale back to the center. Exhale, left shoulder, right knee. Breathing in back toward the center. Exhale, right shoulder, left knee. Inhale back to the center. This time reaching the arms out and up. Interlace your hands. Rest the hands on tops of your head. Elbow open up wide. Breathing in, flip the palms up, lengthening your arms up. Exhale, tilting over to your left side, roll the right shoulder back, press the right sitting bone down. Inhale, back to the center. Exhale, tilting to your right, roll the left shoulder back. Breathing in, back to the center. Exhale, navel in toward the spine, rounding your back one vertebrae at a time. Push your palms away, chin toward your chest. Breathing in, stacking the spine one vertebrae at a time. Lift the arms up. Exhale, circle the arms behind your back. Open the shoulder away from your sternum. Hug your shoulder blade toward the center. Breathing in, lift the chest up. Breathing out, hinging forward from the hips, draw your arms back, chest parallel toward the floor. Breathing in, rising back up, then release, bring your hands back, roll your knee to one side, press yourself back up into your tabletop or hands and knee. Allow your wrist to be underneath your shoulder, your knee underneath your hip, lengthening to your spine, the back of the neck long. Breathing in, exhale, tilting your left hip towards the floor, turn the head to your right. Inhale back to the center. Exhale, right hip down closer toward the floor, turn the head to your left. So try it again one more time, side to side, to just ease off the tension from the side body all the way to the side of your hips. Releasing the tension from the neck and jaw as you turn your head side to side. Then coming back toward the center, Pause right here into your table. Breathing in, tilt the tailbone up, drop your belly down and reaching the heart forward. Lengthening to the front body and exhale, tuck the tailbone down, draw the navel in toward the spine, rounding your back, chin toward your chest. Two more times, inhale as you lift the chest forward, feel like you're arching your back into your cow pose. Exhale, draw the chest and navel to meet at the center, engaging your abdominal into your cat pose. One more time, breathing in, lengthening. Breathing out, contraction, and lift the mid back toward the ceiling. Then bring your spine back into your neutral spine. Bring the left hand right behind your ear. Breathing in, lift the left elbow up. Breathing out, bring your elbow down. Two more times, inhale, lift up. Exhale, soften to your neck and jaw, elbow down. One last time, breathing in. And this time, see what you can extend the arms up. Pause. Exhale, thread the needle, reaching all the way through. Bring your left ear down. Turn the head over to your right side. Option, right arm can walk forward to lengthen your right arm. Surrender yourself down toward the floor and let the gravity do the work. Observing what's happening to your left shoulder, neck, and jaw as you're trying to release the tension. One more breath, breathing in. Breathing out slowly, press your right hand to releasing your left arms back up. Find yourself into your table, noticing the difference, then we start the second side. Inhale, right hands behind your right ear, then lift the elbow up, turn the chest to your right. Exhale, drop the elbow down, relax into your neck and shoulder on your right. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, release, softening and letting go. One last time, breathing in, lift up, and this time, see what you can extend right arms up. Draw the right shoulder away from your chest. Exhale, thread the needle, reaching all the way through, relaxing right shoulder down, right ear down, turn the head to your left. Then exploring whether you like to extending left arm forward, and draw your left shoulder slightly up. Noticing the right shoulder blade moving away from your midline. Relaxing to your neck and jaw. One last breath, breathing in. Breathing out slowly, press to your left hand, releasing right arms back to find your table. Breathing in, tuck in the toe, lift the knee off from the ground, tailbone up toward the sky, find your downward facing dog or upside down V shape. Adjusting hands and feet position that you find the weight evenly, maybe walking your feet forward to shorten your stand. Once you find the downward facing dog, then begin to paddling to your feet by bending one knee at a time, walk the dog. Stretching the back of your leg from your Achilles to your gastroc up toward your hamstring. Engaging abdominal by drawing the navel in toward the spine and lift your tailbone up high. Allow your torso to be lengthening down toward the floor as if you press your ribcage toward your thigh bone. Then begin to bend your knee, inhale, looking forward, walking your feet forward toward your hand, standing forward fold. Relaxing to your spine by bending your knee, bring your ribcage toward your thigh bone. Allow the crown of the head hanging down, hands can grab into your leg or into an opposite elbow. Nodding yes. Allow your torso to gently sway side to side. Continue to breathe and try to let the crown of the head down, look towards your knees so that the tension melting down from your shoulder, neck, and jaw. Breathing in, begin to releasing your hands to grab to your thigh bone, sinking the tailbone down and shift the weight down towards your heel, lift the chest forward. Breathing in, arm forward. Exhale, open up the arms out wide, front of the chest open. Breathing in, arm forward. This time, exhale, twist your right left hands outside your right thigh, right hands behind your back. Chest turn to the right. Inhale back toward the center. Exhale, draw the arms back. Rest your rib cage toward your thigh bone, chest parallel toward the floor, squeezing into your belly, stimulating your digestive system. Breathing in, shift the weights back toward your heel, lift your arms forward. Exhale, twist your left side, right hand outside your left leg, left arms behind. Softening to your jaw, relaxing to your shoulder. Inhale, bring your arm forward. Exhale, sinking down deeper. Breathing in, push down to your heels, squeeze your inner thigh, buttock, widen your arms, softening to your shoulder. Exhale, bend the elbow, open the chest, tilt the chin up. Breathing in, reaching up tall. Breathing out, circle the arms behind your back and roll it down. Inhale, reaching up tall, lift the shoulder up toward your ear, exhale, side it out and dropping it down. Then begin to draw the right arms out to the side. Take a deep breath in, exhale, cross the right arm over to your left, bring your left elbow to support. Drop your right shoulder down. Breathing in, begin to turn the chin over to your right. Option. Drop your right ear down toward the floor, relaxing to your neck and jaw, particularly on your left side, to lengthening the left side of your neck. Breathing in, tilt the chin, gazing up toward the ceiling. Breathing out, draw your chin down. One more time, inhale, exhale. Inhale, bring your head back up. Exhale, release. Breathing in, arms out, reaching up wide. Exhale, bend the elbow, open the chest, squeeze your tailbone down toward the floor. Then slowly release. Breathing in, left arms out to the side. Exhale, cross over, bend your right elbow, drop your left shoulder down. Deep breath in, exhale, turn your chin over toward your left shoulder. Exhale, tilt left ear down, relaxing your right shoulder away from your right ear to lengthening the right side of your neck. Breathing in, tilt the chin up. Breathing out, draw your chin down toward your armpit. One more time, inhale, exhale. Breathing in, release, draw the arms out, reaching it up toward the sky. Left hands will grab into your right wrist, lengthening the right side and draw your right shoulder back. Exhale, tilting over to your left side, keeping your shoulder and hips in the same line so that you're stretching the intercostal muscle, the space into that rib cage. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, release, letting go of your hands, reaching the fingertips up. We switch side, right hands grab into your left wrist. Breathing in, exhale, tilting over to your right, roll the left shoulder back. Feel the weight down towards your left heel as you lift the left shoulder away. Inhale back toward the center. Exhale, release, draw your arms down. And find a tennis ball. Grab that tennis ball, put it down toward the floor. Then begin to find your feet hip width apart, hands to your hip, softening to your knee, making a gentle circle to your knee, hips, and ankle. Then reverse the circle to the opposite side. Then we pause right here, sending the breath energy down underneath your feet and noticing how is it that your feet connecting down toward the floor.
When you're ready, then shift the weight toward your right foot, lift your left heel up, and step to find your tennis ball, then roll forward and back. Just gently massaging underneath your feet, stretching the fascias, you can roll forward and back, side to side. The next time that the ball comes to the back of your heel, you will lower your toe down toward the floor. Then releasing both hands on top of the left thigh, exhale, press your heel down toward the tennis ball, bend your knee. Inhale, shift the weight towards the toe, toward the ball, the foot to lift the heel. Exhale, press your heel down. One more time, inhale, exhale, pressing it down. Then slowly come back up, hands to your hip, roll the tennis ball towards the ball and curling with your toes. Spread your toe apart like you, the crab clawing. And then just roll forward and back, side to side around that ball, the foot and the toe. Then slowly bring your heel down, bring both hands back toward your thigh. Breathing in, press with the ball, the foot, hugging with all the toe, curling it in. Breathing in, point the toe up toward the ceiling, press your heel down toward the floor. Exhale, press your toe down toward the tennis ball. One more time, inhale and exhale. Then slowly rising back up, roll the tennis ball back and forth and bring the tennis ball towards the arch area. Then begin to make a circle clockwise, counterclockwise. Some of you, if it's new to you, you might feel very tenderness. Just be mindful, just slowly, doesn't have to press it so much. Reverse the circle or move side to side, forward and back. Then slowly release the tennis ball down and press your left foot down. Take a moment to checking in. Can you feel the difference between your left foot and the right foot? Right? You feel that grounding. Now we're going to try to balance it out. So bring it to the right side. Roll forward and back. Do whatever your body feel good about it. It's like somebody massaging your feet, right? So as you find it, then bring the tennis ball all the way to the back of the heel, bending to your right knee. Breathing in, exhale, press your heel down toward the tennis ball as you squeeze the tennis ball. Inhale, shift it, lift the heel up. Exhale, press the heel down. One more time, inhale, lift up. Exhale, press the heel down and hold. Breathing in, rising back up. Roll the tennis ball back and forth. Bring it all the way to the top, to where the toe and the ball is. Then curling it in, hugging in. Press to the ball of the foot, bending to your left knee, inhale. Exhale, squeeze. Breathing in, point the toe up, shift the weight towards your heel. Exhale, squeeze. One more time, inhale, exhale. Then slowly rising back up, bring the tennis ball towards the ball of the foot, making a circle clockwise, counterclockwise, massaging whatever make you feel good. Then slowly move the tennis ball away, press your right foot down, feel and noticing how your feet feel. Then hands to your hips, breathing in, rock forward toward the ball of the foot, lift the heel up, hug your inner thigh, press your big toe. Find that balance into the ball of the foot, engaging your calf muscle, strengthening your ankle. Exhale, releasing your heel down right away. Shift the weight towards the heel. Lift the toe, flex the toe up toward your knee. Lift to the arch area. Try one more time. Inhale, rock forward. Lift the heel up. Exhale, bring your heel down. Flex the toe toward your knee. Then gazing forward, lengthening the back of your neck in a very slow motion. Lower your toe down. Feel that grounding effect. Then we're going to start our balance by shift the weight towards your right foot. Inhale, lift your left heel up. Exhale, draw the toe back. Then flip the toe, point the toe towards the back. Lengthening your left thigh bone by lift your hips up away from your knee. Breathing in, reaching right arms up, lengthening the right side of your body. Exhale, slow motion, draw your left toe back and turn the knee out to the side. Left heel towards your right ankle. Staying right here, or take the next option where you bring your foot towards your calf or all the way up towards your inner thigh. Remember to listening to your body. You can always take the option where the toe down. Once you find yourself balanced, you can reach the left arms up, finding your three pose, Vipassana. Softening to your shoulder, maybe widen up your arms. Feel your torso lengthening to reaching up toward the sun. And allow the exhale grounding down toward your right foot. One last breath. Inhale. Exhale, release. Bring your left foot down, arms down. Feel the effect of balance. Then open up your feet wide, twisting side to side to ease off all the tension. And bring the balance to both legs. Try to lift the opposite heel off from the floor as you twist to help protecting your knee. Then slowly find your way back to your stillness into your mountain pose or Tadasana. Then begin to bring your hands to your hips. Shift the weight toward your left foot, breathing in, lift your right heel up. Exhale, slow motion, draw your toe back, flip the tops of the feet down toward the floor. Then adjusting it to bring your pelvis level and drawing your right hip away from your right knee to lengthening and releasing into your quadricep and your shin bone. When you find yourself steady, breathing in, lift the left arms up. Feel that psoas muscle from the left side. Reaching it up away by draw your shoulder away from your hip. Exhale, slow motion, draw your toe back, turn the right knee out to the side, right heel, left ankle. Then taking your time, when your body ready, move your right foot to where you want it to be. Once you find your legs steady, rooted down toward the floor, then begin to reach in that right arms up. Softening to your shoulder and jaw, focusing on your breath, lengthening to your torso. One more breath, breathing in, breathing out, slowly release. Bring your arms down, bring your foot down. Checking your leg out, open up your feet wide, open up the arms out to the side at the shoulder height. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, lift your left heel up and begin to slow motion. Turn your torso all the way to the right. Once you cannot turn anymore, find that edge. Then drop your right arms down to grab your right leg. Lift the left arms up, left armpit up toward the ceiling. Tilting right ear down toward the floor. Find that length onto that left side as you draw your left fingertips away from your left heel. Breathing in, left arm forward, right arms behind. Exhale, bring your left heel down, turn your torso back toward the center, noticing the difference. When you're ready, then lift your right heel up, breathing in, exhale, turn your torso and arm all the way until you find the edge. Then drop your left arms down, breathing in, reaching left, right arms up, draw your right heel and right arm away from each other. Continue to breathe, one more breath, inhale, exhale, open up the arms out wide, then untwist, bring yourself back toward the center, walking forward towards the tops of the mat, and if your block is not in the front, then put the block right in the front. so that during the practice, if you need to use it, you don't twist and turn. Softening to your knee, breathing in, draw the arms out, reaching it up toward the sky. Breathing out, bending your knee, hinging forward from the hips, leading with your heart, forward fold, down toward the floor. Inhale, halfway up, hands press to your thigh bone, chest pale toward the floor, lengthening the tailbone and crowd the head into an opposite direction. Exhale, release, bring your hands down, shift the weight toward your left foot, step your right foot back just enough that you can bring your right heel down. Turn the toe to facing to the front of the room. Then slowly bending to your left knee, bring both hands toward your thigh. Lift yourself up, so lower the right heel down. Now if you're in a tightrope, wobbly heel toe your left foot to the corner edge. Make sure your left knee is stacking on top of the left ankle. Gently squeeze into your right glute. Draw your pelvis right here, the pelvis tilting it up, not collapsing forward. Lengthening your tailbone down towards your heel. So see that if your hips still sway to the side, try to turn your toe to face the front of the mat to the right corner of the mat. Rather than let the toe turn out to the side, you want the toe to turn forward. Bending this knee, inhale, draw the arms out, reaching it up toward the sky. Breathing out, right arm forward, left arms back, twisting over to your left. Inhale, reaching the arm forward and up, squeeze into your right glute. Exhale, draw the left arms behind, then begin to lift your right shoulder up. Drop your tailbone down, so that you're stretching the front of your right rib cage to releasing the tension into your psoas muscle. Breathing in, breathing out slowly, bring both hands toward your thigh, hinging forward from the hips, draw your tailbone back. Option, lengthening to your left leg by bring your tailbone back, draw your heel down toward the floor. Then slowly releasing the hands down, breathing in, begin to turn the left toe, right toe over to your right side so that you're in a wide leg forward fold. The 10th toe pointing forward, option grabbing the block to help lengthening your arm. Once your 10th toe pointing forward, see whether you can draw your heel slightly away and turn the big toe in, like a pigeon toe. So that way is allow your tailbone to draw it apart, relax into your hips, then crowd the head down. Nodding yes, allow your torso to gently sway side to side. Now engaging your leg muscle. You're gonna feel like you draw your heel apart and press to your big toe, squeeze your inner thigh in. That way you're engaging your outer hips and inner thigh. When your body ready, breathing in, bending your right knee, walking both hands toward your right, lengthening your front leg so your left leg is straight, your right knee is bending. So find your right knee, bend to your right knee, straighten your left leg as if you draw your left heel away from the right. Breathing in, walking your hands back toward the center, right hands down toward the floor, left hands behind your back. Breathing in, roll your left shoulder up toward the ceiling, option left arms up. If your pelvis tilting, draw your right tailbone back so that you keep your pelvis level, engaging abdominal. Breathing in, exhale, releasing the hands down. Then begin to turn your left toe forward, right toe forward. Coming back to your lunging position, grabbing the block to frame your foot. Put the block inside your left foot, heel toe your left foot towards the corner edge. Lifting to your right heel, straightening to your right leg, draw your thigh bone up. Breathing in, exhale, releasing the knee down toward the floor, untuck the toe.
Then slowly as you exhale, begin to shift your left tailbone back. Bring the block with you to help you lengthening your arms. Softening to your shoulder, flex your left toe toward your knee. Breathing in, point the toe forward. Breathing out, flex the toe, shift the left tailbone back. Look forward so that the back of the neck are long. One more time. Inhale, point the toe forward. Feel the tops of the feet stretching all the way to your shin bone. Exhale, flexing it back. Then slowly press your left foot down. Bring the block forward, hands inside your left foot. Inhale, extending left leg behind. Press the heel away, adjusting until your wrist underneath your shoulder squeeze into your left glute. Option, draw your right arm forward into your spinal balance. Reaching arms and leg to an opposite direction, engaging your core, your abdominal. Exhale, right hands down, left toe down toward the floor. Turn the right toe out to the side, roll the left shoulder, left hips up, reaching left arms up into your lean side plank pose. Option, draw your left arm forward, bring your left heel and arm away from each other. Let the energy flow to that left side of your body, stretching all the way to your intercostal muscle. Deep breath in, breathing out, release. Bring your hands down, knee down. Open up your knee wide, about mat width apart, big toe touch. Then shift the tailbone towards the heel. Let your torso rest down toward your thigh bone. Crown the head forward. Lengthening to your arms into these child pose and allow your front body to slender down toward the floor. Breathing into the back area, particularly your lower back, mid back, upper back. Exhale, heart melting down. Then begin to circle the arms behind your back, lengthening your arms, then roll your shoulder away from your chest, hug your shoulder blade in toward the center. Breathing in, option, arms up toward the ceiling into your yoga mudra pose. Exhale, tilting right ear, right shoulder down, turn the head to your left, letting go of the tension in your neck, shoulder, and jaw. Inhale, roll your forehead back toward the center. Exhale, left ear, left shoulder down, turn the head to your right. Breathing in back to the center. Exhale, drop your arms down, drop shoulder down, palms. And taking your time to reflect your practice. Inhale, extending the arm forward. Begin to lift your tailbone up, tuck in the toe, breathing in, extending the tailbone toward the sky, lengthen to your leg, find your downward facing dog. Paddling to your feet a couple of times, releasing all the tension. Then slowly bend your knee, breathing in, walking your feet forward toward your hands, standing forward fold. Inhale, halfway up, hands to your thigh bone, half forward fold. Exhale, folding your torso down. Then we shift the weight towards your right foot, step your left foot back, bring your left heel down, toe pointing forward. Bending to your right knee, bring the hands toward your thigh, support your torso up. Once again, if your hips sway, heel toe your right foot out to the corner edge. Then turn the left toe forward to bring your left hip forward, right hip back, rooted down toward your right heel. Breathing in, draw the arms out, reaching it up toward the sky, widen your arm to softening your shoulder. Hug your waistline in, rib cage in so that your back is not arching. Exhale, left arm forward, right arms back, turn your torso to your right. Inhale, draw the arm forward and up, lengthening your tailbone down, ribcage rolling in. Exhale, right arms behind your back, then begin to reaching the chest up toward the ceiling.
These will help stretching your psoas muscle, which is in the front of your rib cage, to hook up toward your quadricep or femur bone. Deep breath in, exhale slowly, bring both hands toward your thigh bone, hinging forward from the hips, navel in toward the spine. Bring your chest parallel toward the floor. Breathing in, draw your right tailbone back to lengthen your right leg. Exhale, release, bring your hands down toward the floor, then begin to turn all the toe to your left side, widen your leg, allow the 10 toe to point forward. Wrapping the block, if you like to lengthen your arms. Once you find yourself into a wide leg forward fold, then relaxing the crown of the head down by looking towards your thigh bone. Let the back of the neck long. If you still feel tension in your neck and shoulder, nodding yes, or let your torso gently sway side to side, the gravity will draw you down towards the earth. Now, if your leg is still not into your pigeon toe, then draw your heel apart, turn your big toe slightly in. That way it helps bring your sacrum balancing and let your tailbone apart. When your body ready, then begin to bending to your left knee, breathing in, walking both hands toward your left foot, lengthening your right leg, stretching that inner thighs and outer hip as you draw your right heel away from your body. Breathe, relaxing to your jaw, keep pressing down your right heel away, feel that stretch to the inner thigh. Inhale, walking the hands back toward the center, then left hands down toward the floor, right hands behind your back. Breathing in, exhale, twisting to your right so you're gonna face forward with the right shoulder up toward the ceiling. Noticing if your left leg or the left hip come forward, press your left tailbone behind. Option right arms up toward the ceiling. Breathing in, breathing out, slowly release, bring your hands down. Then begin to turn your right toe forward to face the front of the room. Lift the left heel up, walking the hands forward, then grabbing the block inside your right foot. Then adjusting to find that your right knee on top of the ankle, pressing your left heel to lift your left thigh bone off from the floor, softening to your shoulder and jaw. Slowly releasing your left knee down toward the floor, untuck the toe. Breathing in, exhale, shift the tailbone back, bring the block back with you to lengthening your right leg, stretching to your hamstring, half Hanuman pose. Inhale, point the toe forward. Breathing out, roll your heel to flex the toe back toward your knee, shift the right tailbone away from your heel. Breathing in, point the toe forward. Breathing out, flexing the toe back. Hold right here. One more breath. Inhale. Exhale, press your right foot down, walking your hands forward, then move the block away, both hands inside your right foot. Bring your wrist underneath your shoulder. Inhale, extending right leg behind, press the heel away, lengthening to your thigh bone. Allow the toe to point forward. Feel like you squeeze the inner thigh on your right side towards your left, engaging your glute. Next option, extending left arm forward away from your right heel. Lengthening to the front body, relaxing to your jaw, engaging your core area into your midline. Breathing in, breathing out slowly, bring your left hands down, right toe down toward the floor. Inhale, left toe turning out to the side, right toe to your right. Then roll your right shoulder, right hip up toward the ceiling, reaching left arm, right arms up. Option, draw your right arm forward away from your heel. Continue to breathe as you're lengthening to the right side of your body.
into your knees, kneeling side plank pose. One last breath, inhale. Exhale, bring your hands down, bring your knee down toward the floor to find your table. Walking your hands forward, lengthen your arms until your elbow down toward the floor, forehead rests on top of the mat into your puppy pose. Try to keep your hips on tops of the knee. So try not to shift your tailbone back if you want to stretch it more towards your upper back. So bring your hip forward, lengthening to your arms, softening to your chest. Continue to breathe. Inhale, begin to press to your hands. Walk your hands back to your table. Tuck in the toe. Breathing in, lift the tailbone up toward the sky. Draw your ribcage toward your thigh bone, then lower the heel down into your downward facing dog. Breathing in, shifting the shoulder forward on top of the wrist with the top of the push-up or plank pose. Exhale, knee down toward the floor, kneeling plank, untuck the toe, lift the chest forward. Exhale, bend the elbow, hug the elbow toward your ribcage, lower the chest down toward the floor, Chaturanga Dandasana. Breathing in, peeling shoulder chest away from the floor, hug your elbow toward your ribcage. Then begin to extending the arms back, point the fingertips toward your heel. Option in, press the hands behind, roll the shoulder apart, lift your chest away from your belly, feel the weight toward your ribcage, the tops of the thigh bone, all the way to the tops of the feet. Locust pose. Next option, you can lift the toe up, point the toe back, lengthen to your knee. Breathing in, breathing out, slowly release. Bring the tops of the feet down, hands down underneath your shoulder. Stay right here, inhale, lift your shoulder up. Option, lengthen your arms, roll the shoulder back, draw your chest away from your belly, upward bow pose. Deep breath in, exhale, bend the elbow, begin to slowly releasing your front body down, turn the chin to one side, doesn't matter what side. Then letting go of your arm, bring your arm along the side of your body, and surrender yourself down toward the floor, feel the weight of your front body heavily connecting down towards the earth. Then begin to bend your knees, sole the foot up toward the ceiling point and flex the toes. Circle your ankle clockwise, counterclockwise. Roll your knees side to side to ease off the tension into your lower back, to your hips and spine. Pause right here by press the tops of the feet down, bring your shin back on tops of the mat, hands underneath your shoulder. Breathing in, press your hands, bend the knee, coming back to your table. Then shift the tailbone towards the heel, bring your hands toward your knee, coming up to your sitting. Roll the hip to one side, extending the leg out, down toward the floor. Bending into your right knee, bring the right foot to the outside of the left thigh, or the left sitting bone, then bring the left foot to the outside of the right thigh. If this is too much for you, you can just sit in cross-leg or using the block by putting the block underneath your left foot so that the both sitting bone are down toward the floor evenly. Once you choose that whatever option is, then the right hand's gonna wrapping around your left chin bone, reaching your torso up, breathing in, exhale, begin to turn your chest and chin over to your left side. Option, draw the left arms right behind, fingertips down toward the floor. Root it down toward your tailbone, inhale, lengthening your torso. Breathing out, keep your torso right there, but turn only your shin toward your right shoulder. Only turn the chin to the right shoulder, Then drop right ear down away from your left shoulder. Breathe, inhale, exhale, lift your head back and turn back to your left side, uncrossing your arms and uncrossing your leg. We switch side, left foot toward your right sitting bone, right foot to the outside of the left thigh. So choose the option that works for you, whether you need a block to support. Left hands wrapping into the front of your right shin bone, lengthening your torso first. And as you exhale, begin to turn your torso to your right. Feel the weight of right sitting bone down toward the floor and begin to circle right arms behind, fingertips down toward the floor. Inhale, lengthening towards the crown of the head. Breathing out slowly, only turn your shin over to your left shoulder. Once you find the edge, then tilting left ear down toward the floor. Feel the lengthening to the right side of your neck, softening to your jaw. Breathing in, lift the head back up. Exhale, turn the head towards the right side. Then uncrossing your leg. Scooting forward towards the tops of the mat, hands underneath your thigh. Press down toward your heel, point the toe toward the ceiling. Then begin to leaning slightly back, lengthening your arms, draw your chest away from your belly. Relaxing to your face, your jaw. On your next exhale, see whether you can squeeze in your belly. Then next option, lift both feet up into your upward boat pose. Next option, releasing your arms away or extending the leg out. Choose whatever option you want and engaging your abdominal, working on your core to strengthening to your lower back. Two more breaths, breathing in and breathing out. Last one, inhale, exhale, release everything down. Letting go of your belly, rest your hands on tops of the feet, torso on tops of your thigh. Continue to breathe. When you're ready, we're gonna transition to lie down toward the floor. So move all the blocks and belts away. Find yourself lying down toward the floor. I'm gonna turn the mat to the side so that my feet won't point to you. Once you're lying down toward the floor, then begin to draw your thigh bone toward your ribcage, knee toward your shoulder. Open up your knee wide so that your shoulder are apart, shoulder blade resting down toward the floor. Breathe. Inhale. Exhale, slowly release both feet down toward the floor, walking your heel closer toward your buttock, feet hip width apart, arm along the side of your body. Inhale, pressing down toward your feet, lift the hips up, point your knee forward on tops of the ankle, lengthening to your thigh bone into your bridge pose. Option to roll your arms underneath your body one at a time to hug your shoulder blade with the center, front of the chest expanding, squeeze into your buttock. Breathing in, lengthening your thigh bone forward, open up the front of your hip flexor. Exhale, feeling engaging into your glute muscle by squeeze your buttock. One more breath, breathing in. Breathing out, releasing your arms out wide, then begin to roll your upper back, mid back, lower back, and the last thing to come down is your sacrum. Rest your body right here, that feel the weights of your body down toward the floor. Then begin to cross, bring your arms back and crossing your right ankle on top of the left thigh, flex the toe toward your knee. Make sure the back of the sacrum are down toward the floor evenly. You can use your right hand to draw your right thigh away from your body, Or take the next option where you lift your left foot off from the floor, draw your left thigh bone towards your ribcage. Noticing what happened to the right side of your glute, to your hips. Ease that tension off, maybe rock your hips side to side, massaging the back area. Pause right here. Lower your left foot down, open the arms out wide at the shoulder height level. Breathing in, exhale, roll both knees over to your right into a twisting position. Then it's option to turn the head to your left. Relaxing to the spine area, allow your body weight and gravity draw you down towards the earth. One more breath, breathing in. Exhale, uncrossing your leg, roll your left knee up, followed by the right, bring your arms back, pause and notice the difference. When your body ready, cross left ankle on top of the right thigh, flex left toe toward your knee. Keep the back of the sacrum down evenly, left hand then can draw your left thigh away. Next option, lift your right foot off from the floor, draw your knee toward your chest. Allow the back of piriformis muscle on your left side to stretch. You can roll gently side to side. Then we pause right here, breathing in, breathing out, right foot down towards the floor, open the arms out wide at the shoulder height. Exhale, roll both knees over to your right, to your left side, relaxing to your shoulder. Draw your right arms away from your body. Option to turn the head to your right. Noticing how your spine release. One more breath, breathing in, breathing out, uncrossing your leg. Roll your knee back up and bring your arms back, pause and feel. Then slowly grabbing the block, bending your knee, breathing in, press your feet, lift the hips up and sliding the block underneath your sacrum, the flat area below your lower back and slightly higher than your sitting bone. Once you find that spot, then begin to reaching the arms overhead, lengthening to your torso. Next option, extending the leg out down toward the floor one at a time. Press your heel down, then point the toe forward. These will help releasing all the tension into the front body from your quadricep, hip flexor, and psoas muscle. Continue to breathe into your ribcage and let the ribcage expanding in all directions. At the tops of the inhalation, let the breath hold right there so that the ribcage expanding and pause. Then exhale, slowly release, letting go. Try it again, breathing in, filling up your lung. And then hold it at the tops of the inhalation, expanding your ribcage as most capacity you can. Exhale, then release, letting go. Begin to bring your arms back, bending your knee one at a time. Bring your foot flat down toward the floor. Breathing in, lift your hips up, sliding the block away. And begin to rest your body down toward the floor, pause and feel. On your next exhale, begin to draw your knee toward your armpit one at a time. Soar the foot up with the ceiling, hands right behind your thigh. Point and flex the toe,
Circle your ankle clockwise, counterclockwise. Allowing this reversing inversion happy baby pose to help draw the blood reversing back toward your digestive system, your heart, your cardiovascular, and to the crown and head to releasing the nervous system to calm down. You can rock your torso side to side, ease the tension off from your back, get ready for your relaxation. When your body ready, then begin to lower your foot down toward the floor one at a time. Extending the leg out down toward the floor. Let your toe turning away. Widen your leg. Draw your arm slightly away from your body. Adjusting and making the movement until your body find a confident ease. Then surrender yourself down toward the floor. Let your body melting down towards the earth with each exhale. Softening to your face, your jaw. Eye can be gazing up or closing your eyes. Allow the tongue to fall to the top roof of your mouth. Giving your body a permission to rest right here. The time to enjoy your relaxation. The time to connecting to your breath and riding with the waves of your breath to the journey of your deep relaxation.
Slowly begin to bring your awareness back towards your body. Allow your head to gently turn side to side, wiggling to your hands, your toes. Breathing in, reaching the arms overhead, stretching yourself in all directions, including by pointing the toe forward. Find that space. Exhale, bend your knee one at a time. Option to draw that knee up toward your chest. Bring your hands on tops of the knee. Roll yourself side to side, massaging your back area. The next time you roll to your right side, using the bottom arm supporting your head, neck, and shoulder, and draw your knee up toward your chest, just like you're curling into the mother's womb. Taking your time to stay into this sideline position to allow your nervous system to slowly begin to return. When your body ready, using the top hands to press yourself up, find your way back to your sitting position and begin to feel the weight of your sitting bone rooted down toward the floor. The lightness into your torso as you're stacking the spine one vertebra at a time up towards the crown of the head. Rest your hands on tops of the thigh. Begin to scan through your body and witness your experience. Checking into your physical body, noticing the quality of your breath, the stillness into your mind, the calmness and relax that you create. Allow all these positive feelings be with you till the next time you meet. Breathing in, draw that arms out, reaching it up toward the sky and allow the palms to touch. Exhale, floating that hands right in front of your heart as we bow forward. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining the practice with me today, and have a wonderful Sunday. We'll see you back next week, 11 o'clock on Sunday. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.